Hi guys, how are you? Jamboni saseni bon?
Bonsoir.
Yeah, it's bonsoir, it's evening. I think you've even noticed Simon is yawning. Sai, are you tired?
A little bit.
Really? I saw you yawning. But you promised you're going to hold on. I remember I said we can do the video tomorrow and Amani told me something. Amani, what did you tell me?
That we should do the video.
And why?
Because you promised.
You see guys, Amani is telling me when you promise to do something, mom, you have to hold on and do it. And I'm like, okay, 2021, I'm going to change. I'm really going to try. I think I have a problem. I like promising because I feel like it's good to give hope. And then I realize that at the end of the day, I have so much to do that I'm not able to do something. God help me that when I say I'll do something that I really do. And if I don't, guys, I know you have so much love. Ama, you'll just forgive me. So for those who don't know me, my name is Alea Mugure Dittman. I have a YouTube channel. It's Lea the Dream Chaser. Just in case you haven't subscribed, 2021, just go subscribe. I'm at 200. I'm so excited. Guys, you can't believe what one subscriber means to me. And even more to that, when somebody comments and I can see that you took your time just to type a word or two, I get so much excited. It's like Christmas. Did I see you yawning? Do you want to go? You want to participate? If you say you stay, you stay. You want to go? You want to go to bed? I take you up? No? Sure? We do it. We rock it. So, guys, we are back again. And we are going to be speaking about something very interesting. Yesterday, we had already said we are going to be speaking about our life with au pairs. We have been lucky to have au pairs for a couple of years since our small baby was a baby. He says now he's no longer a baby. Sai, how old are you now? Guys, they are yawning, but don't worry. We have to pull this together. We have to do this together. It's not so late, but last night was long. Sylvester, people were getting into the new year, the crossover, and we stayed really long. We were awake, like you too. I believe you're also tired, or maybe you'll be watching this movie when you're not so tired. But we have to pull this together because it's even the boys who really pushed me that we do this. And we are doing this just to honor one of our very best au pairs. And what's her name?
Anissa.
Anissa, this is for you and also Valencia. Among all the au pairs that we had, we just felt like we need to shoot this video. Anissa, we know that when your kids get to watch this one day, they'll be proud of you as a mom because you made me proud also as a mother. I wouldn't call you an au pair anymore, like you were once our au pair. You've become actually the sister to my brother, to my sons, and like my daughter. You know, if anybody would ask me, I would say that's exactly who you are. And I would like to say thank you so much. We'll speak a bit of you. I think I'll give the boys the floor. But before I do this, I would like to just say something very shortly. You know, when you invite somebody into your home, we call them au pairs because we need help. I remember I came as an au pair to Germany years ago. And the reason why I came is because I was looking for greener pastures. And that was the only way that I could get into the country easily. And I looked after a baby who was 3 months. Just a moment. Michelle, that's a bit loud. It's okay. So, I had a kid. I took care of a little baby. Her name was Julia. She was 3 months old. And I remember how happy the mom was just to have this this moment that she could call her own because she had somebody. And I remember when I finished school and I wanted to go back to work, I remember a friend of mine told me, Lea, I mean, why can't you take an au pair? And I asked myself, actually, why aren't we doing this? Because my husband works full-time and I was really wanting to get into the corporate world. I really wanted to work. Guys, you can't believe I wanted to earn money like nobody's business. And that's when I looked at the requirements of an au pair and we were actually meeting all of them and we chose to take one. Our first experience was a very bad one. Boys, you remember? Our first au pair, we waited for 7 months to get our first au pair. She was coming from Cameroon. She actually came. But funny enough is they tricked us. Our first au pair tricked us big time. And it was a sad story. You know, she used to, I used to communicate to somebody else. I don't know why I was so naive. I never even thought of maybe video calling her. I just trusted her. We never went through an agent, which we do now. It's expensive, but we can only recommend anybody. If you want to have an au pair, if you want to take an au pair from outside, that you go through an agency. Because our first au pair, we got her online. We liked her. But unfortunately, she used to give somebody else the phone who used to talk to us. When we picked her from the airport, I realized that it was not her. And it was a really sad story. Guys, it was sad. You know, I think I remember the airport when I picked her up and her family was there from Germany, came, took one of her suitcases and we had to drive all the way from the airport. It wasn't far. We lived there 10, 15 minutes away from the airport. But I remember I parked the car shortly, like I wanted to fuel, but I wasn't fueling. I had to call my husband and tell him something is very weird and funny because the lady I used to speak to in Cameroon used to be like, hello, Lea, como sava? And the lady I picked at the airport was like, hello. And I thought, but this is not the lady that I used to speak to, you know. Guys, trust me. I didn't know if I should even bring her into our home. You know, it was just the saddest thing that ever happened to us. Going to meet that lady at the airport, you have a bouquet of flowers. You can't even run to her because the sister was the first one to run to her. The boyfriend to the sister, everybody hugging her. They went live, calling the mom, telling her she's arrived in French. I'm hearing all this. I'm understanding. Eh? She never ever told me that she had family here. Guys, our first au pair was a really sad story, but I thank God for her because she got her way into Europe through us. And I believe God wanted to use us to help her to get into the country. I believe she must have done something good, or the mom, or somebody. I don't know, but God just used the right people to help her to get over here. Michelle. Guys, we are sorry. We'll be speaking to Michelle. There's something she's doing over there. She's a little bit loud. So we are all getting attracted, but I believe the boys will concentrate. We are not going to keep you long. We are going to be here for another 5 minutes. We'll speak about whatever we want to say. But I just wanted to say it's after our first au pair that we got really messed up and we couldn't keep her. We had to let her go after 2 weeks. I told her I could forgive you, but I can't forget that you lied to me because she told me the truth. She wasn't the au pair that I used to talk to. But it's okay. She was already here. So what we did, we got a new family in another city. She got a doctor who was single. And I told her, just go there. Be real because the lady doesn't know that you lied to us. And that's when we got our girl. I don't even know what to call her, Nisa. We got her. She was a changing au pair who was also not happy in her family where she lived. And we took her into our family and we didn't even stay for 1 year. We extended for another 1 year. That means we kept her for 2 years. And funny enough, this is the highlight of the story before the boys come in. When Anissa finished being our au pair, she did her social year. And after the social year, she wanted to study languages. And guys, believe what happened. Anissa went exactly to the school where I did my languages, where I did the foreign language correspondence. And that's exactly where she went to school. That means she went to the school where I was. She sat exactly where I sat. Actually, some of the teachers who taught me taught her. And after she finished this, she came to do internship in the company where I worked at Devo Team. She was there for a couple of months. And right now she's working for a very big bank in Dusseldorf. I'm very proud of her. I'm so, so much proud of her that she came in as an au pair. And she managed to pave her way so high, so beautiful. And I don't know. I would speak about you, Anissa, day in, day out. Day in, day out. Even what you did to our next au pair, you know, when your time was up, we got another au pair again from Zimbabwe and Valencia. I remember whatever Anissa did to her, training her, showing her how to go along things, how to board the train, how to, you know, just do things here and there. I can't really talk enough. Let me see what the boys have to say. So, boys, you have to tell us your experience. Tell our people, tell people who are watching us your experience with au pairs. How has it been? Simon, we start with you. How was your experience with au pairs?
Good.
Yeah? Can you tell us something small, something short? What did you like most about them?
The help does with homework.
Pardon, I can't hear you. I believe
the help does with homework.
They helped with your homework. And what else?
They played with us and gave us food.
They gave you food. Okay. And what was the best part of it all?
They helped you.
They helped mommy. Thank you so much. So you realized this, right? Yeah? And your mommy, what was your experience with au pairs?
Like, it was nice.
Yeah?
They helped us.
Yes?
They helped us with homework, like yes. I said.
Yeah?
And she could rest when they were...
Pardon?
Taking care of us. You could rest or go out.
When the au pairs took care of you.
Yeah.
Did you like it? Would you wish for another au pair?
No.
Like, would you want more au pairs or it's enough with au pairs?
I think it's enough.
Why?
Because we are old enough.
Okay. You feel like you can do everything by yourself now?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I could even take care of Sai.
So that... Sai, did you hear that?
Like, you already did it.
You already took care of him?
Yeah, a lot of times.
And when you take care of him, does he listen to you?
Yeah.
So you do? Yeah? So now that we have somebody who is with us now, and you're saying you don't want more pairs, so she should stay or go?
What do you mean?
We have an au pair right now. We have somebody who is helping us. Mm-hmm. And you love her or not?
Yeah.
What's yeah?
Yeah, we like her.
A lot?
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think we still have Ajani, Amani. Guys, I think the boys said that they don't want any more pairs, but I think we are going to take one more again because I just quit my job the other day. I call it the other day because the pandemic was really hard for me. It looks like I just quit my job the other day. I haven't really gotten to the climax of my job, and I think we're still going to do this one more time just for me to become stable, that I'm sure the kids are safe, that we always have somebody who can help us when it comes to taking care of them. And let's see how it goes. I believe you can never get enough. Amani is still he's 12, he's turning 13, but until they are 17, you're allowed to have one. Like, we can. And I usually tell myself, if you're able to bring people in here and it works for them, like it worked for me, it's somebody who believed in me and invited me to come and take care of her daughter, that I got a chance to be here, and I thank God that I managed to stay. And the same way we've been able to bring in au pairs, that two of them are very successful right now. Some are still studying, but I believe one day we look back and say, look at those ladies. And I think it's something nice. I'm so happy, guys. That's our experience with au pairs. And I would like to tell you guys, give it a try. If you know that you're working really hard and you sometimes feel like you don't even know what to do, you don't know what to do with your kids, of course we could take them for daycare. But when I moved into my husband's place, like where we lived before, the kindergarten, it was a private one, it was very expensive. And we looked at the cost at the end of the month and we thought it would be cheaper to take an au pair. And that's the reason why we went for au pairs. And for au pairs, you have them 24/7. Of course, they have their free days over the weekend or according to how we plan. But for us, it was the best choice. The kids learned English way too early. Amani Anissa did a lot of works. His phonetics, it's just here maybe on the camera that is a bit nervous. But normally in school, they're actually among the best kids. And I'm really happy about that. I have to thank them. And I want to thank you, Anissa. Just one day, when you sit down and listen to this, when your kids sit down and listen to this, may they be proud of you. Thank you for making my kids shine. And you know what, Anissa, remember, you are right behind Jumbo African Dishes and even right behind Jumbo Swag. When I came back from Kenya, I remember I told you about my dream to do fashion, and we were looking for a name. I remember when I was telling you you should call it Nairobi Finest and all this, and you're like, Mom, no. And you helped me choose the name Jumbo Swag. And then it came a time when I wanted to cook, and I remember we sat and thought again, and we got this name, Jumbo African Dishes, together. Anissa, I got you. I thank God for you. When you watch this one day, just remember you did a lot for us. We are so grateful. Even my husband, he's a fan of you. Whenever we talk about you, we see how much we feel, how much love is in us just because of you. Thank you so much for choosing to be with us, and God bless you so much. So guys, what do you have to say?
Bye-bye.
Bye.
See you next time.
Have a good night. And what should people do who haven't subscribed?
Subscribe and like the video.
If they like it, thumbs up. If they don't, thumbs down. So guys, we love you so much. Have a very nice evening. And it's still beginning of the year. We want to wish you a very happy 2021. Stay tuned. May your dreams come true. May you live to shine. And guys, just do it. We love you so much.
Bye-bye.